Valence shell electrons. The valence shell is the outermost shell. And I hope it makes sense that if we had two atoms that were going to interact with each other, as they approach one another, it's going to be these electron clouds that really bump into each other. And the outermost electrons would play a especially key role. And those would be the electrons in the valence shell. A very important principle is that valence shell electrons give rise to chemical properties because they're the ones that are interacting. There's an easy way to predict the number of valence shell electrons for any of the elements. For group A elements, the group number is equal to the number of valence electrons. Let's look at the periodic table and I'll show you what we mean. Group A elements are found here on the left-hand side, the first two columns, and then these six columns to the right of the periodic table. We don't apply the concept of valence shell electrons to the center elements, the transition elements, or the inner transition elements. This first column, group 1A, they all have one valence electron. Those elements in group 2A have two, and so on. As we get over here to the right-hand side, group 3A has 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and finally 8 valence shell electrons. So it's really pretty easy to identify the number of valence electrons as long as you have access to a periodic table, and you always will. Let's practice the concept. Element 56 is barium. It has a total of 56 electrons, but because it's in group 2A, it only has two outermost electrons, two valence shell electrons. Or if we were to pick something over here, element 52, tellurium, for example, it has a total of 52 electrons, but it's in group 6A, so it has six valence shell electrons. So you should be able, for any element in group 1A or 2A, or these elements on the right-hand side, be able to identify the number of valence electrons.